Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. In this video, we will learn about the construction, working and the characteristic of the enhancement type of MOSFET. Now, if we talk about the construction, then in some aspects, it is similar to the depletion type of MOSFET. So, if we see the construction of the N-channel enhancement type of MOSFET, then the substrate is made up of P-type material and through the metallic contacts, the drain and the source terminals are connected to this N-type material. And similar to the depletion type of MOSFET, this oxide layer isolates the gate terminal and the P-type substrate. But here, unlike the depletion type of MOSFET, there is no channel between this drain and the source terminal. So whenever we apply the control voltage between this gate and the source terminal, then the channel is formed between this drain and the source terminal. So here, in this type of MOSFET, basically the application of the control voltage enhances the number of charge carrier in this region, and due to that the channel is getting created. And that is why this type of MOSFET is known as the enhancement type of MOSFET. Alright, so now let's see the working of this N-channel enhancement type of MOSFET and let us understand how the channel is formed whenever we apply the control voltage. So initially, here if VGS is kept 0 and if the voltage is applied between this drain and the source terminal, then due to the absence of the channel, there will not be any flow of current through this MOSFET. So whenever VGS is 0, then this MOSFET will remain in the off condition. Now let's see what happens when we apply the positive value of VGS. So here, the substrate and the source terminals are connected together, and they are connected to the ground terminal. And the positive voltage is applied between the gate and the source terminal. And for a moment, let us assume that this voltage VDS is equal to 0. Now, holes are the majority carriers in this P-type substrate. And whenever we apply the positive voltage at this gate terminal, then the holes which are near this oxide layer will be pushed away from this gate terminal. And at the same time, the electrons which are the minority carriers in this P-type substrate will also get attracted towards this gate terminal. But at the lower voltage of VGS, these electrons will get recombined with this majority charge carriers. Now, as we keep on increasing this voltage VGS, then the holes will be pushed more and more deeper into the substrate. And the electrons will be able to overcome the recombination with these holes. And they will be rushed towards the gate terminal. But due to this insulating layer, they will not be able to cross this oxide layer. And they will start accumulating near this oxide layer. So eventually, the inversion layer of free electrons will get created near this oxide layer. And now this inversion layer will act as a channel between this drain and the source terminal. And now, suppose if we apply the voltage between this drain and the source terminal, then the current can flow through this channel. So the value of the gate to source voltage at which this inversion layer is getting created is known as the threshold voltage. And below this threshold voltage, there will not be any flow of current through this MOSFET. And whenever this VGS is greater than this threshold voltage, then the width of the channel will increase. So in this way, due to the application of the voltage VGS, the channel is formed between the drain and the source terminal. But along with this channel, there will also be a depletion layer around this channel. Because if you observe, there are two PN junctions which are reversed bias. So the first PN junction is formed between this drain and the substrate, and the second PN junction is formed between this substrate and the source terminal. And if you observe, right now both the PN junctions are reversed biased. So now we will consider that this voltage VGS is already greater than the threshold voltage. And now let us see what happens when we apply the voltage VDS. So when we apply this voltage VDS, then through the channel, electrons get attracted towards this positive terminal. And in this way, the current will be established in this circuit. And the conventional current will flow from the drain terminal towards the source terminal. But now if you observe, the width of the channel has been reduced towards the drain side. because now due to the positive voltage at the drain terminal, this PN junction will get more reverse biased, and due to that the width of the depletion region will increase. So because of that, the effective channel width towards the drain terminal will reduce. And the same phenomena can be also explained in the another way. So once we apply the drain to source voltage, then the voltage difference between this gate and the drain terminal will reduce. So the voltage difference between these two terminal will be equal to VGS minus VDS. And as this source or the substrate terminal is grounded, so we can say that this difference will be equal to VG minus VD. So as the value of this voltage VD will increase, then the difference between these two voltage will reduce. On the other end, this source terminal is connected to the ground terminal. So the voltage difference between the gate and the source terminal will remain as it is. So due to that, the gate terminal, which is towards the drain side, will be less positive than the other side. And hence, this region will attract fewer electrons compared to the other side. And due to this reason, the channel width gets narrower as we go from the source terminal towards the drain terminal. And as we keep on increasing this voltage VDS, then at one particular voltage, pinch off condition will occur. So at that particular voltage, the drain current which is flowing through the circuit will get saturated. So the voltage VDS at which this pinch off condition occurs is known as the saturation voltage. And this saturation voltage can be expressed as VGS minus VT, where VT is the threshold voltage. That means the pinch off condition will occur whenever the difference between the gate and the drain terminal is just equal to the threshold voltage. Because at the threshold voltage, the channel is just getting created between the drain and the source terminal. So for the fixed value of VGS, if we further increase the value of VDS, then the difference between the gate and the drain terminal will be even lesser than this threshold voltage. And due to that, the channel will not get formed towards the drain terminal. So it appears that the current through the channel should become zero. But actually, if you see, still the current will flow through this channel, and this current ID will get saturated. Because the electrons which are passing through this channel can still be able to cross this depletion layer due to the electric force. So once the pinch off condition occurs, then the current ID gets saturated. And even if we increase the value of voltage VDS, then still the current through this circuit will remain almost constant. So if we see the drain curves or the ID versus VDS curves for the different values of VGS, then it will look like this. So as you can see, as the value of VGS will increase, the current ID will also increase. And this parabolic curve shows the locus of the voltage VDS where the drain current ID will get saturated. So in this graph, this region is known as either linear or the ohmic region. So in this region, the MOSFET can be operated as a voltage controlled resistor. So for the fixed value of VDS, as we change the value of voltage VGS, then the width of the channel will change, or we can say that effectively the channel resistance will change. So whenever VDS is less than VGS minus VT and VGS is greater than VT, in that case the MOSFET is operating in this linear region. And in this region, it can be operated as a voltage controlled resistor. Then if you talk about the next region, then it is the cutoff region. So whenever this voltage VGS is less than VT, in that case, the current through the MOSFET is zero. Or we can say that the MOSFET will remain in the off condition. And then after, if we talk about this region of operation, then it is the saturation region. So whenever the MOSFET is operated on the right hand side of this locus, then we can say that it is operating in the saturation region. So mathematically, we can say that whenever this voltage VDS is greater than or equal to VGS minus VT, at that time it is operating in this saturation region. So this is all about the drain characteristic and the different regions of operation of this enhancement type of MOSFET. So similarly, now let us see the transfer characteristic. So the transfer characteristic shows the relationship between the input voltage VGS and the output drain current ID. So basically it shows how the drain current ID changes as we change the value of voltage VGS. And while plotting this characteristic, the voltage VDS has been kept constant. So as you can see, up to the threshold voltage, the drain current ID is 0. And after that, as we increase the value of voltage VGS, then the drain current ID will increase. And the relationship between the current ID and the voltage VGS can be given as ID is equal to K times VGS minus VT whole square, where the K is the device constant and it depends on the physical parameters of the device. So using this expression, we can find the value of the drain current for the fixed value of VGS. Alright, so far we have discussed the N-channel MOSFET. So similarly, let us briefly talk about the P-channel MOSFET. So in case of the P-channel enhancement type of MOSFET, the substrate is a N-type and through the metallic contacts, the drain and the source terminals are connected to this P-type material. But now, in case of this P-channel MOSFET, the polarity of the voltages will be reversed. So now, the channel will be formed whenever the applied voltage VGS is negative. And mathematically, we can say that the channel will be formed whenever this voltage VGS is greater than VT. And the current starts flowing through the channel whenever we apply the voltage VDS between the drain and the source terminal. So for the P-channel MOSFET, the pinch-off condition will occur whenever this voltage VDS is equal to VGS minus VT. But here, all the voltages will be negative. And for the P-channel MOSFET, now if you see the drain or the output characteristic, then it will look like this. But here, now this current VDS and the voltage VGS will be negative. And the drain current ID will also flow from the source terminal towards the drain terminal. So as you can see from the graph, as VGS becomes more and more negative, then the drain current ID will increase. And whenever this value VGS is greater than VT, then the MOSFET will operate in the cutoff region. And similarly, if you see the transfer characteristic, then it will be the mirror image of the N-channel MOSFET. So this is the brief overview about the P-channel type of MOSFET. So at the end, now let us see the symbols of this N-channel and the P-channel MOSFETs. So the symbols are quite similar to the depletion type of MOSFET, but here the line which connects the drain and the source terminals is a dashed line. And basically it indicates the absence of the channel under the no bias condition. And if the substrate is internally connected to the source terminal, then these symbols are used to represent these MOSFETs. Apart from that, the only difference between the N and the P channel is the direction of the arrow. So if the arrow is going inwards, then it represents the N channel MOSFET. And if it is going outwards, then it represents the P channel MOSFET. So this is all about the symbols which are used for the enhancement type of MOSFET. So I hope in this video, you understood the construction, working and the different characteristic of this enhancement type of MOSFET. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.